Why is it when you install something, you're left with a box of leftover parts? This shouldn't be right. If you're looking for LED or HID headlights, taillights, backup lights, this company is pretty good. Check them out. So today is vehicle maintenance day. Yep, not changing the oil, that's already been done. Don't need to change the spark plugs or wires, that's been done as well. But I had to get rid of the old headlight assemblies and change out the bulbs from what I was using to something that actually works. So, pretty cool. Found a seller on eBay that sells OEM replacement headlight assemblies for 2008 Saturn Vues and got them installed. So if you look at the old ones, yep, they are hazed over. They got that, what do they call that shit? It's like a mold or something on them. And the headlights that I was using, I ordered them online a long time ago. And I tell you, these suck. This is a pretty much a plug and play. These are LED. There's four on one side and four on the other, high intensity LEDs. This has a built-in cooling fan in the back of it, and then you have your power supply right here, and this just plugs right into your stock harness that's inside of the lens. Yes, I said inside of the lens. So as you can see here, you have a main plug that comes in, and then it feeds your high beams and low beams. So yeah, pretty simple. And then there's a cap that kind of goes over these two as well. But yeah, these things suck. After a while, the fan, you can actually hear the fan on the inside of the cab when these things turn on. And I end up having a problem where one bulb, half of the LEDs went dim on me. And yeah, be the last time I buy those again. But the HID system that I used, there is a ballast inside of here. I have it mounted to one of the support bars that's in the back of behind the assembly. And there also is a amp or starter kit that has to be connected to these. Now, I went with a, what did I go with it? It's a 5,000, 5,600 or something like that, or 6,000 series, as far as the number goes for the light. So it's going to have like a little bit of a blue tint to it, but it's going to be a white. So all your lines on the road and everything else will be kind of, they'll glow. And even in the rain, these things work really, really nice. They're better than a conventional bulbs. Conventional bulbs, yellow. And, you know, getting a conventional halogen bulb that has the white tint to it, or the blue hue to it, or whatever you want to call it, they're not as bright. They're still a halogen bulb. So these guys are pretty good. I mean, I'm going to turn it on right now. All right, so as you can see, got it lit up. These puppies are pretty bright. They're HIDs again. And the only thing, I have to wait till it gets dark so I can aim them properly. I don't know how well they're aimed because I went from the stock one that was already aimed to something that is an OEM replacement, but don't know how well they're adjusted. So it's got the shield over the light, just like the OEM does. And you know, here you have your high beam, your turn signal, parking light, whatever you want to call it. This comes with no light bulb, so you're going to have to get your own. So what do I do with the old assembly? I mean, the old assembly is not broken or anything. I mean, this could be fixed. Basically, how you would sand down and polish a finish, you would basically do the same thing with this. It is still reflective. I mean, obviously, you can kind of see it's still a reflective, but it's got that fucking crap on there. This, well, obviously, where that's... And you know what? I don't need these hanging around the garage. I got brand new ones on them, so the trash they go to. Plastic, recycle. So this thing here, this is my MTX, my 210-inch, in a ported enclosure. Now I can't remember what this port enclosure is called, but it has the port comes down here and actually L shapes behind it, and I think it wraps around again. This box slams. I mean, even with these 10s in it, this thing slams. But between the box and these subs, these are not the cheap MTXs. These baskets have a lot of weight to them, including the magnet. And yeah, I ain't picking this thing up anymore. So once I vacuum this thing off and get kind of like all the dust off of it and everything else, I'm going to sell it or give it away or whatever to one of my buddies, or whoever wants to buy it. These are nice subs, but with my back being the way it is and shit, I needed to go with something a little bit smaller. Look at all the stickers. So how small did I go? Well, let's see here. I didn't go that small. I went with a Pioneer 12 inch DVC wired for 2 ohms, and this is the TSA 300B, 500 watts RMS, and it's supposed to be like, I don't know what it is supposed to be, 1800 watts peak, which I don't go by the peak at all. Not a bad sub. Overdrive it and it will distort. My thing with it is because I had two 10s inside of here that take a little bit more power, actually a lot more power, than what this 12 takes, I have to turn the gains down on the amp. And it's not fun to turn the gains down on my amp because my amps are underneath here. So I gotta do that right now.
I tell you, the weather doesn't know what to do.
It's trying to rain. Actually, it has rained a little bit. Grass is growing, needs to be watered though. We need rain, we need heavy downpour. Come on, rain, goddammit. Overkill. 12 gauge stinger, solid copper wire, 100% oxygen free. Yeah, a little bit of overkill, but it gets the pounding done. I mean, gets the job done. Class D amplifiers is the way to go nowadays. No more of this power that's not being used. Class D's, you're basically pretty much efficient nowadays. So on the left side, we have a GMD 861 monoblock, and basically it's 1 ohm, 800 watts, 2 ohm, 500 watts, 4 ohm, 300 watts. And I have mine running at 2 ohms, so I'm pushing 500 watts. And then we have the 4 channel, which is on the right, which is a GMD 860x4. Basically the same thing. I'm running that at 2 ohms, so I'm pushing 500 watts with that as well. So this is where I hide them. Where the spare tire is, it's got a perfect spot right there. Now the problem with this is that this side is all your power and inputs and outputs. This side is where your RCA input is, and also where the gain control is, which makes it very hard to get to because I need to turn it down, because right now I'm pushing that 12 a little bit too hard because I was running the dual 10s, MTXs, and 2 ohms. So let's see if I can get that done.
Yes, let's get a copyright strike. So as you see, I'm using a Pioneer head unit. I have the subwoofer control right down here, and in all four doors are infinities. Much better. Before, the sub was overpowering everything. Now it sounds pretty good. Alright, I have an unboxing to do. Actually, a couple.
Yes, so it finally started to rain just in time because I went inside. So I have a little bit of an unboxing to do. This kind of came in today, and I couldn't remember what it was until I got an email, and something I've been waiting for a while, because a lot of places didn't have it in stock. So this came from Sweetwater, I believe. So I think my kid's going to end up getting some candy, I think. All right, yep. Sweetwater. Oh, And I got another Sweetwater sticker. Yay. Yeah. Oh, they're getting kind of chimpsy on their candy. Used to give you more than that. All right, so what do we have here? I've been kind of saving boxes a little bit because you never know when I'm going to be shipping something out to somebody. All right, so this is something that I found online, and it comes with a nice little case. What, you gotta put your own stickers on these things? What the hell? All right, so what these are special nut files. All right, they're diamond coated. So let's see what one looks like. This is supposed to be the 10. These are diamond coated nut files. A little bit on the rounded side as well. So when you're filing your nut, that you know, that's got a nice seat for the string to sit into. And you're not gonna have to worry about hitting the headstock with these. Kind of nice. So I got a whole set of these. These are for 10s. And yeah. Now I just need something to use them on. Smarties. All right. So after I get done chewing here, nice thing about Smarties, they kind of dissolve in your mouth as you're chewing. Kind of nice. All right, I think they're done. All right. So what do I got here? Well, this was something I was looking at a while back, and actually a very long time ago I was looking at this, and I've been kind of waiting for the next model number up to come out. Now, they do have a model number that's higher than this one here, but they're like $300 and some odd. So I went with the next model down. Now, when I first saw these, I think they had like a series one at the time. I'm not too sure, but I know it was pretty of a low series. And this is when I was looking for a certain type of earbuds or in-ear monitors. So I found this. This is going to be easy to open. Oh yeah, it's going to be easy to open. And this is what I came up with. These are the Fender FXA6s. Now they have a 7. The 7s, like I said, are like $300. These are really nice. And from what I've been reading about these, as far as sound quality goes, now I use my Zune headsets for everything. And I like them, but they're for my Zune MP3 player, you know, Microsoft Zune. And, you know, eventually I'll end up putting them back with the, or want to put them back with the Zune, because obviously the Zune is no longer supported by Microsoft, but I still use it. You know, I still have music on it, and, you know, it's kind of nice to take with you when you have no phone service, like at the cabin. So yeah, these things are supposed to be, I know they come with a very nice case, that's for sure. How do you open these? There's got to be a way here to get these out. I don't want to pull on them. All right, so what do we do here? Boy, this thing is snapped. We got to pull the string. There you go. So you got your headsets, which they do not have the little earpieces in. You have to put them in yourself. And these are really, really, really nice. Come with a nice little carrying case. And I think these come with like a screwdriver as well. I'm not too sure what the screwdriver would be for. Yeah. They come with a little... I'm gonna figure out what that is. Well, okay, never mind. This is a cleaning brush.
kind of nice. And then you have your adapter. Now these in-ear little rubber pieces here, right, they're not foam, they're actual rubber. And there's three different sizes here for depending how big of an ear you got, okay? And when you put these in, with just like any in-ear buds, you want to make sure that they seal inside of your ear, kind of canceling out outside noises. And you'll know when they're sealed because the low frequencies actually start sounding correct if they're in, if they're put in your ear right, using the right adapter for it. Quick start guide. All right, so it's got a little cleaning tool. All right. Instructions? Who needs stinking instructions? So yeah, so I'm going to end up trying these things out and kind of listening to them later to see what kind of a sound quality they're actually got. I wish there was a way that I could monitor the sound quality as far as, like, you guys can hear them as well, but it's a little bit kind of like, can't do that. And these also are detachable from the wire as well. Nice braided wire, not cloth. I don't like the cloth. I do like the cloth ones, but I don't like the cloth ones. And these do have the over-the-ear, if I can get these damn things out, over-the-ear. I don't want to break this. Come on, get out. There you go. So when you put them out on in your ear, you know, they sit around the back of your ear. Yeah. These look like they're going to be really, really nice. All right. They have screws. Look, there's screws in the back. Take it apart. No? Yeah. Shouldn't do that. All right, folks. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. You guys take it easy. Have a good one. I'm going to eat some candy.